What can you tell us about Cuffins? You know, a relationship with him. Can you describe him with words or anything?
Yeah, dude. Cuffins is an absolute legend.
Happy New Year, Mr. Cuffins. You did some amazing things this year, bro.
Whether it be serenading me with his deep voice.
I know you started off as being a voice, a super iconic voice, and I'm so happy to have found out this year what you look like and have you come full circle as a content creator to finally meet you and not just your voice.
Or just fragging out in Call of Duty. That man's an absolute legend. So much potential as a content creator, but with the voice acting he does, and like, dude, there's so much potential, not only being able to back it up with his skill.
Your YouTube content, you have been killing it.
Absolute legend, and honestly going to be a content king.
Pushing out gaming content, IRL content, literally everything in the books, bro. You've been killing it on YouTube. Keep doing what you're doing there.
Like, my man is, you know, I've seen him, you know, back in the controller days, but now also playing some mouse and keyboard and Call of Duty and everything. He's absolutely nuts. He picks up everything so quick. Anything he touches, he gets good at.
Couple of questions I got, bro. Number one, where do you see your content going in 2021?
I would love to know the backstory of Cuffin. How did he get into content creating, and what is it that inspired him to do this?
Do you want to just, you know, continue IRL stuff on YouTube, continue gaming, or do you have like some other secret plans that you have for 2021 content? And number two, bro, what kind of goals do you have for 2021? Whether it be a certain amount of followers on a platform or subscribers, let me know what kind of goals you got for 2021, man. Happy New Year. I really appreciate you.
Super stoked to see what he's got coming in 2021, and I know my dude's going to kill it. Shout out, Cuffins.
Good luck for 2021, and peace out.
It gets deeper from here on out.
What's going on, guys? It's your boy Wavy, and today I just wanted to talk about my boy Cuffins. So this video will be dedicated all about Cuffins.
I'm going to be talking about like how I met Cuffins, you feel me?
I was super excited to see that my boy got a face cam. Like this year his content has definitely stepped up, and with him adding a face cam to his content and stuff, and seeing him and his personality and his content all match up together, it was super exciting to see.
I met Cuffins because I was on Kobe, my Kyle montage from Black Ops 4. This is before I met anybody in TD. I was still like new and all, right? So I saw Kobe and he was like, yeah, I like his Black Ops 4 montage, it's pretty nice. He got gold on his guns and all of that, pretty good. Cuffins immediately said, bro, anybody can do that, that's kind of easy. And I was, bro, in my head, I'm thinking, dang, you don't want to give me props, crazy, bro, that's real, that's crazy, right? I'm like, bro, he got to be hating or something, bro. I went to his Instagram, I started looking, and I'm like, hey, yo, cut it, bro. He not even hating, he just, his shit just better. Keep it a buck, bro. Bro, I got that challenge mentality, so I was like, all right, but if I lose, bro, at least I'm walking out of it with like some experience of playing better players. When it was like that, bro, it was hard. I heard his voice and I'm thinking, bro, he gotta be like 27, bro. Nah, this man sound full out grown. I was like, yeah. But like me and him, bro, we both share like the same comedy. It was more like we're just being funny, bro. It wasn't must sweat, go crazy on the sticks. It was that like just joking around and stuff like that. So we really became cool because like, it was just comedy, bro. We was like just being funny, bro. And we just became cool like that.
I'm super interested to see how moving forward for 2021, what kind of games he plays, you know, what kind of content, what direction he ends up going, whether it's, you know, more IRL vlogs. I know he's been doing a little bit of that this last year, and some funny moments stuff. So I'm curious to see what direction he goes, maybe a little bit collab of both. If he leans over towards one than the other, I don't know. We'll see.
And that comes from, he helped me out with like a lot of the stuff that I do today, like with my content and stuff like that, help me edit with my Streamlabs, OBS, all of that. So I want to thank him for that. And my boy Marcel, yes sir, bro, you got it, bro. But I got a couple questions, bro. Where do you see yourself in the next 10 years?
Is what direction would you like to see yourself, you know, going towards more IRL content, vlogs and stuff, or what are you looking at? What are you most confident and passionate about?
What goals do you have for 2021? Peace out.
When I first met Cuffins, you know, he was a good guy, very hardworking, very diligent in his work. I taught him how to edit using Sony Vegas and so forth, and yeah, that's pretty much it. On my end, he's a good learner. He's kind of stubborn sometimes, but yeah, I'm hoping to see a lot of great things for him in 2021, but 2020 was not it for him. Yeah, like, I'm telling you, like, I gave him all the tools to be successful, but he's still ass. So 2021 is, you know, he's going to redeem himself. So, yeah, I'm happy to see him. And, yeah, we'll see where this takes off. Good luck, Cuffins. And, yeah, I love you, dog. And take it easy, Zeus. Damn, I'm so good at these things.
Shut up, bitch.
When I hear the word Cuffins, I'm like, what is that? What kind of name is that? I didn't know too much about Cuffins. He was a great gamer, but that's all I knew him as. You know, he was just a regular gamer to me on our rosters until we start pushing people, you know, testing their game, testing their content, you know, just see what they're about and what they stood for. And, you know, for me, he stood out and he separated himself from other individuals. He never complained. He never talked down on others. He kept himself self-motivated. He was a coachable player. What I mean by that is he wasn't afraid to take criticism. He wasn't afraid to learn new things. He wasn't afraid to try something new. He wasn't the Mr. Know-it-all kind of guy. And he was just, you know, all ears. There's certain things he did know, but when he don't know certain things, he will speak up and ask, you know, for help. And, you know, I know because, you know, this whole year working with a guy like Cuffins, you'll see it. You'll see it. And you know, his hard work and dedication, you know, I see it. I've seen it all. And for me, you know, I built a personal bond with him. I felt like he's my little brother. Cuffins is really talented. But there's for sure some things he needs to work on. But I know it's not going to be a problem for a guy like him. So, Cuffins, if you're listening, I want you to know that, you know, all 2021 is going to be our year when we came up from nothing.
All right. Marcel Boswell hyphen White, a.k.a. Cuffins. Cuffins is a guy I met around 2018, 2017. One of the first in TD. When I met Cuffins, it was through mutual friends, through Wavy, Somatics, Jose, etc. We were playing Fortnite, and I realized that, you know, this guy was really good. So I challenged him to a 1v1 on Fortnite. You can ask him how that went. He already knows what's up. Nah, for real though. Yeah, from then on, we kicked it off after that one night. We would play Fortnite every single day together. We would make content together. We would stream together and build more of a friendship. Not more of a friendship, but like more of a brother type on, you know. First impressions of Cuffins, I knew, you know, his family. He was raised in a good family who don't really have a lot, but they had each other and, you know, they worked with what they had. That's one thing that I can relate to. You can see that passion, the drive, all of that, you know, implement into his content, and that's just how he is. That's just where Cuffins came from. Cuffin moves in silence. Like, he doesn't really talk too much, but you know he's getting that work done. Some words that I would use to describe Cuffins would be determined, humble, but yet confident. He knows his place and time, but yeah, he has the confidence in himself to be the best in TD. And I know a person like him, 2021 around the corner, and you know, the sky's the limit for this kid. He has so much determination, so much drive and work ethic. It's you can't match it. So yeah, Cuffins, I want you to know that I love you, bro. Keep pushing for moms, keep grinding, and I promise things will unfold for you. You have so much potential. You keep doing you and inspiring others that it is possible to do it, and I'm excited to see what Cuffins brings to the table in 2021. Yeah, brother, appreciate you so much.
Hey everybody, this is OGLN. I'm here to share some things about Doobie. You know, y'all might know him as Marcel. Some might know him as Cuffins. It's a lot of things I could tell y'all about my son, but I'm going to get straight to the point. You know, he's a fine young man. You know, he's growing into his own. You know, when he was born, I knew he was special. I knew he was special. You know, he liked to get in things. He liked to venture in things. He liked to just find out what things were. He used to mess with the pots, pans, beat on them. He used to just do a lot of things that, you know, normally Little babies don't mess with stuff like that. He mess with remote control, remotes, you know. He used to mess with the controllers of the video game, and he actually thought he was playing the stuff. But then, you know what I'm saying, all of a sudden he got older. He started playing the video game with me. Then he started playing it with me and his mother. And then, you know, he graduated from playing video games, playing games on the phone, cell phone. Then he went from cell phones, and then, man, he must have found his niche, man, because I tell you, man, my son, he took off. When he started messing with that PC, man, he really took off, man. That PC, it turned into a beauty for him, you know? Now, he's streaming, he's gaming, he's doing a lot of things, man. He's editing, you know. I tell you, like they said to Michael, that the boy is bad. The boy is bad. I'm proud of him. I can say I'm a proud father of Cuffins. You know, he's growing to be an excellent young man, and I just pray and I hope the best for him to keep growing. In 2021, ain't nothing can go but go up for him. So I just want to tell you, son, I'm proud of you, and I want you to keep doing what you're doing, keep inspiring people, keep grinding, and be yourself and stay humble, son. But until then, I love you, son, and you keep grinding, and you don't stop. Don't get tired. You keep moving forward and do your thing.
Happy New Year's, everybody. I'm Cuffin's mother, for y'all who don't know who I am. I'm going to be talking to you about my baby. To me, his name is Doobie. That's what we call him around here. I won't tell you his other nickname because he won't allow me to say it. So I'm not going to share that. But I am just going to share some things about him. When I was pregnant with Marcel, I had a dream from the Lord that I was pregnant with the boy that I had been waiting patiently for. I was so excited when I had that dream because I knew for a fact that I was getting ready to have me a boy. And I went up to the doctors and was like, you know, I need to take a test. I'm pregnant. I had a dream that I am pregnant with a boy. They didn't believe me at all. Of course, I sounded crazy to them. But sure enough, they did the test. They came back and it was like, you know, Mrs. Boswell, the Lord is right. You pregnant and stuff. And so they said, all we got to do, we got to wait to see if you're pregnant with a boy. So as time was going on, I was just excited, telling everybody, I'm pregnant with a boy. I'm pregnant with a boy. Nobody believed me. And so I just kept telling everybody, you know, God is not man that he should lie. And sure enough, when it was time for me to go for my, I think it was my 4-month checkup, and they was like, would you like to know the sex of the baby? And when they did it, Marcel did this big flip in my womb, and he had his legs wide open. I mean, he made it known that he was a boy, and everybody was excited, and they was like, you know, looks like God is right. You are pregnant with a boy. You've been telling us this all along. So, yeah, you know, Marcel, he's special. God told me about him from the beginning of my pregnancy. So the Lord gave me another dream about Doobie. And in this dream, the Lord had shown me that Doobie had sprouted, which I should have known this because after I had him, and they had to, you know, put his feet print on the birth certificate, and his heels was hanging off. So they didn't get his whole feet on there because his feet was so long. But I didn't think nothing of it. I just thought he was going to be short. So the Lord has shown me in the dream that Doobie was going to sprout and he was going to be tall. And then also in the dream, he showed me about a contract. But it was a football contract. So we always try to get Marcel, you know, prepared for doing, you know, football. And I was always tell him, that the Lord showed me that he was going to be tall and that he was going to have a football contract. You know, the Lord just showed me that pretty much he was going to be doing something with his life. I love all my babies. You know, Doobie, he strives to be the best that he could be. He have always been someone that cared for people. I remember a time when I was sick and I was laying on the couch. He brought me a pillow and he also brought me a cover. My cover on me, and he gave me a kiss. I would even hear him and his siblings, like when I would fall asleep on the couch, they would come and they would whisper in my ear, "I love you." He has a heart of gold. He's very intelligent. He is smart. He's giving. Man, there's just so much I could tell you guys about him. He always had to explore. And I made them all promise me that they was going to do something with themselves. You know, and Marcel, he made that promise, and I see him excelling. The reason why I say that is because he gives his all. He doesn't have to. He gives his best. And that's what I'm proud of him. He's not only a dreamer, he also put his stuff into action. But I was always able to tell that Marcel cared for people.
Yeah, first things first, I want to say thank you for everybody that participated in this video. It really was fun. Really means a lot to me. If you made it this far in the video, really do appreciate it. You know, really hope you got to see, you know, more about me and just seeing how people see me and just the different things about me. And for the answer to everybody's questions, first question, you know, as far as goals go, I'm just striving to be great. You know, I'm hungry for success, and because my big main goal is helping my family out, I want to be able to give back to them and help them. I want to help us to a point in life that we never got to experience, and I want to be able to help them see that there's more to life than just struggling, that there's more to life than just being sad. And I'm thankful that we're able to keep going and that God helps us out when we need it most. And I want to be able to show that side of the struggle, show y'all how we're gonna come from nothing, and show y'all that I'm very determined. And to answer the question that majority of you guys asked me, for what I plan on doing, you know, with my content this year, I can say I'm really leaning towards making more IRL content. You know, I just find myself having fun doing it and expressing myself more with it, but also find myself expressing myself with gaming too. So I do want to lean more on the IRL content side, but I also want to keep that gaming inside of my channel and inside of my life. For Eric, as far as where do I see myself in 10 years, definitely see myself being very successful. Definitely see myself being able to motivate people, show people, you know, that if I can do it, they can do it. You know, if I can come up from nothing, they can come up from nothing. And definitely want to show them that, you know, just because what other people say you can't do, you definitely can do it. And, you know, like, if you put your mind to it, then you're definitely going to get it done. That if you keep working for it, you're definitely going to get it. Shout out to Big E, because, you know, the question I like to ask people is, you know, what do you do when there's thousands that want what you want? And the easiest answer to that is, you know, you going out and outworking them, out grinding them. You know, you just got to be able to get up earlier. You got to stay up later, you know. You got to be able to execute and go from 70 to 120. And that's what I see myself doing in order to be successful in 10 years. Another question that I got asked was what got me into content. And what really got me into it was meeting Kobe, Trey Bussin. You guys know Mr. Trey Bussin. You know, like, seeing his work ethic and seeing the kind of content he was putting out, and seeing a young guy, you know, coming up from nothing, like putting out content and having fun with it, being able to grow with it, you know, it kind of motivated me to start doing content. So I started. Last but not least, to answer everybody's question, my goals for 2021, definitely fully finding my niche and excelling in it. Really want to grow my audience on all my platforms more. It'll be epic, but I'm not really looking for, you know, to have clout or anything, but definitely to be successful, gonna need an audience. Definitely looking forward to finishing school and graduating. And I definitely want to be able to motivate more people. Thank you, everybody, and I love you guys. Peace out.
In the name of love.